Sania, your host, and this is Date Makers. And I'm here with a handsome bachelor named Greg. Why don't you tell us a little bit about yourself, Greg?
Okay, well, I'm a teacher. I do spoken word. I also run a youth program called the Philadelphia Youth Marshal. Okay, so pretty cool.
Speak, brother, speak.
Okay, Greg, why don't you tell us something that turns you on in a first?
Woman that can articulate critical thought.
Oh, okay. That's what it is?
Intelligence.
Okay.
I find it very sexy.
That's good. Okay. That's good. All right, Matt. Why don't you tell us a little bit about the game?
Well, that was a lie number one. But back to games, Date Makers, where we make you a date. We have three ladies here that are all single, all available, and we're going to learn a little bit about them. Contestant number one, what is your name, and what do you do?
My name is Janine.
Can you speak in there?
Oh.
Intelligence is the one thing that he liked.
Actually, me too. How about that? My name is Javan, and I am in the military. So today I'm just here to have some fun and see what comes out of it. Right?
Don't be offended by anything I said to you. All right, bachelor number two. Name and what do you do?
My name's Lips, and part-time.
No, I'm sorry. What was that again?
Lips.
Okay.
Just looking everyone else.
Where does that come from? Where do you get that from?
I don't know.
Okay. All right.
My name's Lips, and I work part-time, and I go to school part-time.
Nice. Where do you get school?
Harrisburg.
Nice. Harrisburg. All right. Capital city.
My name is Megan. I'm a stylist and an actress.
Stylist and actress. I like that. All right. Well, we are going to start the game here, and Tania, can you give us a little breakdown of what's going on here?
What will happen here is Greg will get these young ladies to play each category, and we'll all get points. And then, at the end of the game, he'll give out his VIP necklace, which means whoever catches his eye the most, he'll give them this necklace. And then each lady has a steel bracelet, and with the steel bracelet...
Ladies, hold up the bracelets, please, for everybody. Those are steel bracelets. Very fashionable.
Yeah. You feel like contestant number one, you can do a better job. If anyone feels like they can do a better job than anyone, you can throw out your steel bracelet and you can steal the points. If you're caught with the bracelet at the end, though, you lose 2 points, okay?
And we got one other guy with us today.
Sure
we have Kyrie is sitting in the audience.
What it do? Date Makers in the building. I'm in the audience with all of my peeps. My peeps in the audience. What's up, y'all? I'm ready to get a crack, and this looks like it's going to be a fun one. I can't tell who Greg liked. I can't tell which one of these ladies is going to show us something, but I'm anxious to see. Audience, we ready?
Woo! Yes!
Let's go.
All right, let's get this game started. So, Greg, you're going to have to pick a category first.
I'm going to say, can you keep up?
Can you keep up? Let's see how many this bad boy's worth. Uh-oh, we got a question mark.
All right, the category is can you keep up? Now, each question is worth 1 point. Now, if you get all three of them right, you get the points. If you get it wrong, one of the ladies can steal it from you, okay?
So it's gonna be 3 questions possible. 3 points, ladies.
Okay, I'm really into sports, especially football. One, and what down does the kicker kick the ball to the other team?
Fourth down.
Right.
Fourth down, all right, I like it.
Okay. Two, how many men are on the field at one time for a team?
We getting a steal before she even answers?
What's that? Can I think about my answer?
Oh, Lick's getting vocal over here.
I'm gonna go with 12.
Damn.
Anybody want to steal it?
Anybody want to try to steal it?
Nobody want to steal it? So I guess I got to...
No steal?
Okay.
No.
It's 11.
So close. She got one point.
All right.
And it's one more. Yep, it's one more.
This one goes to contestant number two.
How many yards are in a first down? How many yards does a team have to get to get a first down?
Let me give you a hint. You have 10 possibilities. You can do this 10 times on the field.
Wow.
Ding, ding, ding.
I wonder how you got that answer, but it's
just running through this
so
right now.
All right, so contestant one and contestant two both have 1 point.
Okay.
All right, let's go to the next.
All right, what's the next category?
Let's do
fine line. Fine line, all right. That's for one whole point. Oh, my goodness.
And this is actually,
one, ladies.
This is an all play.
Let me hear your best pick of line, and we will see which one of you gets the audience's vote.
All right,
I have one too.
A little creative.
I'm gonna put myself in this one.
Oh.
Would you guys get started?
What?
Hold on, Matt. So you got a pickup line for Greg?
When am I gonna try to pick up Greg?
You said you have a pickup line.
You said you were gonna,
so...
you were gonna throw
No, I have a pickup line. I'm
but
not gonna use it on him.
Uh-huh. It's for Greg.
Well, I'm using it for one of these ladies up here, man.
Awesome.
I'm not going for Greg.
We hope
Sorry,
not.
Buddy.
Okay.
That's what you were looking for.
Okay, we can start with contestant number three.
Are you tired? Because you've been running through my mind all day.
Classic.
That's an old school one. I think my grandfather still uses that one.
If it ain't broke, don't fix it.
He's crazy.
Yeah, I'm sexy. Can I buy you a Pepsi?
Damn sexy. Can I buy you a Pepsi?
I like caffeine.
I hope you're not a Coke guy.
I'm kind of cheating over here
because
my thought process is already there. But can I buy you a drink?
Okay.
Can
I buy you a drink?
You like to get your
drink?
Men drunk first. I
understand. Wine and dine. You have to say.
Tell me everything up front, huh?
All right, let's go to Kyrie in the audience.
All right, audience, what do you think about these?
We heard the three ladies' pickup lines. I think one of them was lame.
I think. Agree.
Which one was lame? That was a little lame. Which one was lame?
I'm gonna say contestant one.
Contestant one was lame too. Which one did we like, audience?
I like number
three.
I like number
two. Two. I'm hearing some two. She said, "Hey, sexy, can I buy you a Pepsi?" I kind of want a Pepsi too. I do too. Yeah, I would like to see her drink the Pepsi with a straw. But we going with number two.
Well, besides the product placement, I guarantee anyone of you ladies in the audience, if somebody says, can I buy you a drink, you're not going to turn that one down. Greg, would you turn that one down?
Nah, actually, I mean, hey, buy me a drink.
Buy you a drink? So which one are you going here? Audience says number two.
I like the creativity with number two, though. You know, it was a step up above the can you buy me a drink.
All right, the Pepsi sealed the deal. All right.
That's right.
Show some points. That's 1 point for lips.
Good. All right, now let's go to another category. Greg, pick one.
Okay. Let me see. Let's do tearjerker.
Tearjerker. Okay. The TJ is worth three. Tania, what are we doing for the TJ? Okay.
I'm really into theater, so I like a woman that can act. If you can get an Oscar-worthy performance by dropping a tear on cue, you'll get 3 whole points.
So, ladies, can you stand up for us?
All right, ladies. Let's get up. Let's get in a row. And let's get some tear action
Think
going.
Think about that guy. You want that first heartbreak?
Just think about City of Angels.
You lost your puppies.
Lost puppies. One shoe.
Whoever can make it drop first.
Tupac passing away.
Yo. This is my clef.
No more ice cream in the can. A bowl full of cereal with no milk.
Sitting up here on the face. While I'm on this floor,
I got my girl
down.
One time.
Hey, yo, girl, you already got delivered.
Going away, girl. She's barking it. I need to see one. She's poking her eyeball.
Do that again.
Creativity. I'm getting sick here. I mean, she's like Jim Carrey and that Ace Ventura. This song doesn't remind me of your first dance. That cute guy. Step on your foot. Oh my goodness, this is horrible. I just started thinking about when Golden Girls went off the air, and I get a little teared up. To be honest.
Okay, ladies, are we going? I see number one. We're getting a little bit of reaction from number one, just a little bit.
Someone punch somebody else. Let's get a tear, please. You're in the military.
I see a little bit.
Someone in a sleeper.
It's not going down. That was a 3-pointer too. Nobody.
That was
no
three points.
So it may just go without any.
Points. I'm saying time's up. This is
time's been up.
It's hard.
I'm trying looking at this scene right here. I got to be honest with you.
No crybabies. Number one is really trying over there, though. No,
she is trying.
Her eyes are glistening a bit.
There. It was that easy. I award none of you points. 3 points. I'm crying because those three went to waste.
That was hard, though. That was hard.
That was hard. Greg, let's get another category in here.
Let's pick another one.
That was disgraceful.
I appreciate your efforts. Steal the spotlight.
All right, steal the spotlight. Let's see what Rainmaker's going to get this one. Two points.
All right, so this category is worth 2 points. Let's re-steal the spotlight.
This is your opportunity to tell me why I should not pick either of the other contestants. What do you have that they don't?
Oh, God.
Well, none of you have trying abilities, I'll tell you that much.
Kenny, you should not date contestant number one because she's skin and bones.
Oh.
You cannot date contestant number three because she looks like an albino Jimmy Neutron.
I love Jimmy Neutron.
I do too.
And now that you put it that way, I'm taking pretty.
Wow.
Yikes.
That was
she
went
me because I'm me.
Oh, you're you.
You're you.
I still don't know why they call you that. I honestly don't.
You don't see?
How do you feel about that?
I like her style. I think they gotta steal that one.
No, that was an all play.
Still. Cat fight, come on.
You can do better.
All right, we got a good reaction.
There you go. I like that. All right, what do you got here?
I want to pick the other contestant. I want to pick contestant number two because she looks like a drowning fish.
Oh.
And I would pick number one because her hair is extremely dry.
Oh.
Flavor of
one, you,
love style. What's
you
up, New York?
Want to steal number
got the New York
one?
In the house.
I think I'm going to have to go with another.
I mean,
oh,
wow.
Yeah.
I'm not
going to
insult anyone. I wouldn't date contestant three.
Or
two simply because I'm above the insult. I'm going to give you something to think about. I can also, you know, take you other places, travel the world. Because that's what I do. That's what I'm into. That's why
all right.
Let me tell you why you should date me, not Greg here, number one.
So she won that over, I see.
I like to travel.
Yes. I mean, I'm not going to insult you.
I mean, Greg, what do you think?
I think it's interesting. And it takes intelligence to really, really rise above chaos. And she answered the question. I didn't, you know, it's not snaps or anything. I don't know. I
want to see what the audience thinks. Talk about this on your date.
I want to see what the audience thinks.
Okay, so let's go to Kyrie in the audience.
My folks up top. What's going on? How we doing up here? Anything good? How y'all like them disses? They was dissing the mess out of each other, wasn't they? Man, who we like up there though? I'm number one. Oh, y'all going with number one because she kept it classy. Who disses we like the best, though? Who disses was I? Number three had the best diss? Who diss you like?
I like number two because it was just, she just kept the real as it is, but it is.
I like number two because she spiced it up there.
Is that right?
Number two, she definitely spiced it up.
Do y'all know number two?
No. They're just human neutron pets.
So who we going with, audience? We going with one or we going with two?
I think the audience has spoken. It's looking like number one. She played it safe and won the points.
Thank goodness they didn't even start with the your mama jokes. But anyway, it looks like contestant number one got this game. Greg, we're coming down. We got two games left. Which one are you going with, brother?
How does it feel?
How does it feel?
Yeah.
Oh, 2 points, Tania.
Okay, now how does it feel is worth 2 points. And this is an all play, so all of you ladies get to play. Okay, each of you will be given a prop. Now, you must touch the bachelor on his arm or leg with the prop. If he guesses who you are, you get 2 points. Get it? Okay.
But Greg, if it was only that easy, you got to put on this bad boy blindfold.
Yeah.
Look at you. Let me put it on, Zorro.
I'll put it on for you.
Get it on.
Zorro's is black. Can you hold this for me? Yeah, I'll hold this for you. Dun, 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 dun.
Can you see?
No,
I actually can't see. You should be in the R. Kelly video right now.
There's no...
All right, ladies.
No little people here.
Here is your weapons of choice.
I swear.
My choice.
Yeah. All right, ladies, let's see who's going first here, and I'm going with... Woke up this morning. I guys got to figure out who the contestant is. And last but not least, let's switch scenes real quick, Greg. Alright, ladies. Alright, enough with that. Alright, whoa, before you take that blindfold off, Greg, let me get these props. Alright, remove the blindfold, Greg. How was that, fella?
Last one, man. Damn it, who was that?
Uh-oh.
Alright.
Think about it.
Come on, they all use a little bit of trademark there.
No lips. She kissed my arm.
What? That was you?
And it was like tassels or something. Like, it tickled me or something weird.
Sounds about right.
Thought she was going to put it in my chest here. All right, and I want to say she poked me with her hair or something like that. And she rubbed something else down my back.
You don't want to know. Don't want
it. It was very weird. I was hoping it wasn't something like. Anyway, and one was the last one that I might cross my neck or something like that.
Something like that. You know what she did.
Oh, yeah.
Come on now. Let's not play it safe.
Then it licked my neck.
Oh, she licked your neck?
I didn't see any licking going on.
No.
I don't know what little happy place you were at.
So, yeah, that's what I think.
All right, so that's what you think?
Yeah.
All right, you are correct.
You
are correct with all three of them, but now the points go to the winner. And who turned you on the most here, buddy?
Contestant number one.
I'm seeing a trend here.
Yeah. All right, so.
All right, girls.
It's one left.
We are down to our last game, and I see some of you still have your steel bracelet. That's -2 points. And the game is stunt double, and this is worth 3 points. Now, if you guys have any chance of catching up to number one, you better get this one.
This is hilarious.
Yeah, this is hilarious.
Ready?
Yes.
Okay.
If we are going to shine together, I have to be able to trust my co-star, act out one of these scenes with me. You have one. You have 30 seconds to defuse a bomb. Two. I think you're cheating on me, but you're really not. Three.
Heard that.
Call the last play in the huddle to win the game. The contestant must act out one of these scenes with me.
All right, ladies, so you got three scenes. You have to pick one. And whose turn is it right now? Contestant number one. All right.
What was the third scene?
It's called the last play in the huddle to win the game.
I don't know. You were 1-for-3 on the football questions. I don't know.
Make it good. I mean, it's worth 3 points, so you want to...
I'll go with number three, the last one.
Okay.
All
right, let's huddle it up.
So you and him got to get up there. Ready?
Damn, all right, we're in character already. All right,
she's like that.
We huddle, we football, basketball, right. What huddle we at? We football huddle.
It's football huddle.
All right. Is your
football and
action.
No,
I got to follow you.
You
got to
follow me?
Yeah, you're thinking too much.
How was it?
All right, let's go. We got 30 seconds.
You have like 28 seconds left.
Sing. Are we losing or are we winning?
My God, you're losing.
What just happened to this game?
Welcome back to the game. They're losing.
We got to go. We got 10 seconds. Come on.
10 seconds left.
I'm speaking too much. I can't take you.
Nine.
We're going to go with the one. You're going to cut down the middle, go over to the left, and when you look up,
I like
I'm
going
to throw the ball to you, but you got to catch it.
We should have stayed at cutting down the middle.
Stay down, cutting down the middle.
And scene. I don't, that was... That was total confusion there.
I'm gonna steal that one with number two though.
She wants to switch it up?
Switch it up.
With the rules?
Nah.
You think you're cheating on me? You're really not.
Let's go.
Baby, why would I be cheating?
No, I see you down the street. Yeah. You want. You know what? I'm out. What is wrong with you?
Yo, I'm not cheating on you, dog. Chill.
And cut. Where was the Tyler Perry twist in there? I did not see any hope for you guys.
Like, no, I am going to cheat.
And I don't know if you guys noticed in that one, but Greg actually had a tear swelling up, unlike any of these women could do earlier. Throw that one out there.
Greg, you've been cheated on before?
Yeah.
It's okay.
Yeah.
Man, it's
alright. All right, I don't know about that one.
I think she said, I'm cheating on you. All right, I'm gonna go cheat on you anyway. Then.
Maybe not.
And then called you dog.
I'm dog.
All right,
to the
audience.
We gotta go to the audience with it.
We're going to the audience.
That was crazy.
That was very crazy.
Did y'all feel that? I didn't expect them to be thespians up there. You know what I'm saying? I mean, number one wasn't a thespian, though. I think that was the first time we seen her just fail miserably.
Yeah.
She was winning all games, doing her thing. But that football huddle was a disgrace.
Yes.
It looked like it was a hockey huddle or something. Like, called the last play to win the game, and she asked, are we losing?
And I'm a football fan. You can't ever take football like that.
I don't even, I'm going to just say like this, right? I'm going to overrule the whole audience. I don't care what they say. I'm going to go with number two just because of all of the just tenacity she's shown. She went in.
She did.
Not cheating on you, dog.
In real life, I don't know. I
could
be believed her.
Yeah.
I might
she
have
did.
Acted very old.
Yeah.
Yeah, so
I think number two.
Lips.
They saying team lips in the audience, man.
All right, so with the audience, they went with number two, which she put on a great performance. So lips won that round, okay?
It's got to be Team Lips. I mean, honestly.
She definitely won.
She has a great campaign going right now.
Okay, so now we're at the end, Greg. So, got to give this necklace, your VIP necklace, so one of the ladies that you felt like, you know, caught your eye or had a sexy look, whatever you want. You got to give it a necklace. You can't give it to me, so you got to give it to one of them, okay?
The only downfall of this game.
I got to give it to the person that did earn it, so. Definitely is sexy. All right.
Contestant number two.
Oh, I didn't see that one coming. Uh-oh. Well, unfortunately, ladies, one of you have to leave, and I'm afraid it's Miss Neutron. I'm sorry. Even though your show got canceled and you're kicked off, we still love the show. We'll watch the reruns.
All right.
Adios.
Coming out.
Can we get a space shuttle for her to take off in, please? she's not leaving that cup a little bit though. Uh-oh. A little feisty. Alright.
So we're at the end now. So it's between these two lovely ladies. And this is the Battle for My Love segment. So the last two, you have to play paper, rocks, and scissors, old school. We're going to play three games of that. And the best out of three wins, okay?
Yeah.
The two that you don't want to use, put them on the chair. The one that you want to use, hold it up. So the audience can see. All right, Greg, do you want to get the rock, paper, scissors, shoot countdown?
One, three. One, two, three. Rock, paper, shoot.
Oh, we got a rock and we got a paper. And I believe that, paper covers rock. Which I thought you had street smarts. What is this?
All right.
Guest number one has to leave here. Some action. I'm about to be on the way out like John Paxson.
All right.
I just got to watch you practice.
Using a hook
just as you see it. Just say,
I think she should. All right, let me be a clear winner there. We got the best of three. Contestant number one with the win.
I'm going to do for now, but I'm going to break you.
That ellipse is getting real pissed off up here.
Now we got to get the tally of the points.
All right, we're going to tally up, and I know who the winner is. Greg, I think you know who your winner is. But Kyrie, can we check the audience and see who you guys think deservingly wins this?
I think the race is tight. Who we think won, audience?
One.
Number one? Nobody think number two won? She got the VIP.
What happened to the Lips crew over there?
Yeah.
Team Lips bailing
Team Lips just jumped off the bandwagon.
So she can still win with the VIP?
It was worth two really points. You know what I mean? They gotta tally it up. I really don't know.
We team lips all day. All right, it comes down to brains or lips. And even though she has the M or the VIP, it's like MVP. You still come in number two like LeBron because the championship is number one. And I believe that's contestant number one in this game. Bye-bye, contestant two. Lips. Adios.
Bye, thanks.
We can still go out if you want.
Look, Matt's looking for a hug. Oh,
Matt, you want
to hug? Hey, give me a hug. Come on.
I want to do the whole time.
Obviously. That's an obvious choice.
All right, so, Greg, meet your lady.
Oh, look at that. She didn't even run ahead. So contestant number one is the winner, and we're not letting you guys go empty-handed. Both of you win gift certificates to Purple Petties.
Ooh, nice. Uh-oh.
Yes.
That should be fun.
So I think we made a lovely connection here at Date Makers. What do you think?
I think so.
I do too.
I think it turned out pretty nice. You two lovebirds, you get the heck on out of here because I need to get it up and close personal with my co-host, Tania, over here.
You take this stuff, too.
Oh, okay.
So this was another great episode of Date Makers where we made a nice date, right? You think so?
I think we made a nice. I think the right girl won in this case.
The right girl won, good.
Mm-hmm. Lips was a little too much. She should probably eat me alive, I got to be honest with you.
You love that. I do love that.
I do. Well, hey, stay tuned next time for Date Makers. Maybe we'll make you a date.
Bye.